If you need to combine columns, you can also do that in Power Query. So it's the equivalent of concatenate, the Excel concatenate function. So can you see here we've got three different columns. We need them to look like this. So again, it's in table form, data, get it into Power Query. What you'll see, Power Query's put it in. Again, it's made some guesses on the type. Might always be a good idea just to get rid of that so we can see what we're looking at. We now have the ability to merge the columns, and you'll see quite conveniently here we've got an item here called merge columns. What it's waiting for, it's grayed out at the moment, is it needs to know what should it merge. And all you do is you need to highlight the columns that need to merge. But what's very important is the order you do it in will decide the order of the merger. So we're happy that I'm just going to go in consecutively, that one, then that one. You'll see if I put merge columns, its only question is, how should it merge it? What is the separator? Is there no separator, in which case they'll be right next to each other? Or should you put a column, a comma, equals? There's a whole bunch of them. I'm just going to say, put in a dash, and perhaps give it a name. And when I say OK, you'll see it merges it. The order is incredibly important, so I'm just going to switch that off. And now I'm going to do it the other way. I'm going to go, so I'm going to highlight first the department, then the city, then the client number, for example. When I say merge columns, again, I'm just going to put the dash in. When I say OK, you'll see it's merged it in a different way. So the order you highlight the columns in is very important. But once you've done that, it's just clicking the merge button and telling it how, what the divider should be.